Hi, my name is Vignir. I'm the production manager of Edex Iceland.
When we were beginning here in 2006, we had a different solution.
And then we moved on to Sjukal. We actually tried it again a few years ago, and it's like stepping back to the Stone Age. It's no 3D option there, and it doesn't have as many options for the Sjukal product like Sjukal has. Yeah, we have machines from foam industry in Italy. We just export from Sjukal, import to Unilink, and there we can also make some changes if we want to. But most of the time I don't need to. I just export it straight into Unilink and export again to the machines.
It's a great benefit to be able to draw in 3D. My name is Maria Tarosian. I work for Edex in Iceland, and I'm head of sales for their Sjukal production and Sjukal. I like their user interface, it's much nicer. I like the options, they're very clear. You can see the profiles, and if we have like structured glazing corners or three-dimensional units, then of course we work in 3D. Some architects have Revit models, so then of course we try to provide whatever they need for their models, but currently we are mainly working in 2D.
My name is Martin Rubai. I'm foreman in Edex Glugar aluminium factory in Iceland. Almost every day I'm using Sjukal, when most of the time when we are making so big facets or even just normal small window, and so I can see our workers when I go cross-section. Most of the time for me, when I'm on the production, I see the cross-section, then I can explain to people what kind of gummy, what kind of gasket, what kind of plastic, or what the number, this is the best to find for some new workers or for our workers, because there's so many types. So for me, it's the best to use the Sjukal when I go to cross-section, so I can see every details what I need for production.
We can use iPads on the floor. We can move the FTC around, and in the FTC we can do everything, almost everything. Take a look at all the MCOs and the complete drawings, and it has helped the guys a lot. We don't need any printouts and to be moving around with a lot of papers.
I'm using a lot of DocuCenter also. Most of the time, of course, when I see making something new, because I'm working there some 11 years, so most of things, small details I know. But there is coming always something new, so I go DocuCenter also almost every day, most of the time also to explain some people. Okay, you just go DocuCenter, put the number, so then you can know where you should supposed to put all the small things, small accessories.
I primarily use DocuCenter for finding tester boards and product passports and various fittings and items, especially from archives, because we are servicing a lot of older installations, so it's quite helpful with that, because I prefer to have a meeting with the installers before project start, and I show them guidelines and videos, and also for test documents. So yeah, I use it quite a lot.
I'm quite happy with Sjukal, so that's the main thing, and of course in the future I know the Sjukal program will get better, so it's always evolving.